Say Juan Sentinels. Stand up. Made this a little bigger. I think that's going to show better on the YouTube videos especially. And we go up against the Monarchs this week. The Monarchs are our division opponent. And if I recall, they did a really good job of addressing the concerns. I think they were 31st in passing last season. And between the players that left, the ranking that they were on defense, they spent some money too on offensive pieces. I mean, they did pretty well. Gotta give them credit. I'm trying to remember what we had set up for this week's. But anyway, so they got CJ Stroud, Offensive Rookie of the Year last year, and in real life. Good for him. Low Beautiful. I think it was another Redditor. We're going to see a lot of... One of the things that I do for my subs, followers, people who interact with me on Reddit, Operation Sports, in honor of those players, I put them up here, and this is one of them here. Prince Harry, he was one of the first in the first wave of renamed Zach Moss and Taylor Batty. No fullback, line flashlight. Just appreciate the support. Michael Thomas, Alan Lazard, Amina Sephiroth, which I still wanted to find out if I could show that sword that I have on screen. We play them again. So Kevin Bob might seem simple, but that's actually one of the renames based off of a Reddit username. Elijah Higgins, Payne Durham. So 75 starting off. Ooh, Laramie Tunsil, one of the best, if not the best, left tackle. Because I think we have Tyler Smith, but I think the Cowboys left tackle retired in this league. Wayne Candidate, this is a rookie left guard. 92 strength and mid to high 70s except for pass block finesse, but run block 72, pass block 74, those will go up. By the time this person's 26, 27, those are going to be astronomical, but strength is the one that doesn't go up very often, so good to see a good pick on offensive line. Right now he's formidable despite his 74 rating. Connor Williams, 81. Trey Smith, 85. Mekhi Becton, 79. And Fetty Perk X, left end. This was, again, just giving love back to those who have shown love to me. 79, 74, doing smooth over there. U/Gotham, 94. Morgan Fox, Terrell Boyd. Rookie, 80 speed. All right. Zay Zezer, same thing. Jonah Williams, 85, though. The defense is coming together, and last season that we played these guys, every game, Chisel Donis was coming after us. And, but just this season, since they knew we were going to get so much flack from Chisel Donis, it was okay. Don't cry. And this, again, Reddit username, I love it. 90 overall middle linebacker. The defense definitely improved last year from the 31st ranked pass defense in terms of yardage. And of course they have Jalen Ramsey, so yay, superstar. I'm so Eric stoked. William Jackson, Amber Thomas, and Bryce Belton, rookie. Elite Droxy. This is a Twitch follower that I'm glad to have, 79 overall, but very young, top free safety, going to be a beast for years to come. And then Grant Delpit, Jordan Battle, Grayley Arnold, we've got Trey Wolf, and Albert Wesker from the Resident Evil series. 1 year of experience, 95 kick power, really, 67 overall with 9. Anyway, so that's who we got to face. So what's our game plan? I think defend the short pass is smart because if it keeps us close to the line, CJ Stroud can also be a problem. So I think that's a smart move there. And then what they want us to do on offense is blitz counters. Let's see what how many blitzes they do per game. They do a third of the time they're blitzing. They're mostly in zone coverage though. But I think it's always smart to run inside to at least start the game and then kind of see what position Josh Jacobs puts us in. So we'll do with that. Round table. What's up, coach? 450 offensive yards. You wildin', dog. Now, we've been hitting 300. So we'll see what we can do. 350 offensive yards. I mean, if we're going to go for 450, we're probably going to get 350. Allow 10. Somebody tell these guys. Which, by the way, I did make some changes to the playbook. The playbooks were actually already set. We have the Las Vegas playbook because the Huskies came from Las Vegas Raiders. They were the relocated team from that. And Nick Gregory was his name. And he's the high school coach for a high school team called the Huskies. So I was like, close enough. But Clyde Holland is our new defensive coordinator. And he came from the Eagles staff. So I made so the playbooks were already set, but I changed the style to become the team schemes. And then what I'll probably do next off-camera session is maybe make some changes on some formations that give Josh Jacobs rest, or putting players that I want in prime positions on maybe the kick blocking or kick returning, stuff like that. But I don't think we're going to allow less than 10 points. I mean, their offense ain't all that scary, but it's all Madden, and the way the sliders have been moving, this is not going to be an easy game. 5 rushing touchdowns, you crazy dog. I'd rather go shoot for 200 rushing yards. Or get a pick. The problem is, I can get that and then get 4 points. I can get half of 350. I can get half of 200 rushing yards and get 3, but maybe get the 2 if I focus on it. So we're going to trust ourselves. Now, in the off-camera session, I went ahead and did some drills. Some of them were gold. Some of them were silver. Either way, we don't want that practice goblin anywhere near us, right? Okay, defense looks good. Offense looks good. I do have practice injuries on. I do have injuries on. In fact, I moved it up. It was 11. I think I'm put it at 11 for the preseason. I think I moved it up to 17 or 18, which is might sound small, but those are scary numbers considering we had 2 season-ending injuries last year. Alrighty, we have a mock draft that we'll review after the game. Also, I already did the focus regional positions and stuff like that, but we'll take a look at where we stand. The Wizards have signed Ben Sims. We already knew that. It's time. We are going to Big Ben. Big Ben Stadium. Doesn't say which, what game it is. Is it a Sunday game? This Monday night, prime time? Anywhere? You gonna tell us? It says 1 p.m., so I'm guessing Sunday. Those aren't in chronological order, that would have helped. It's amazing that they're 0-2. Considering that roster, I wouldn't think they'd be easy to beat. So yeah, 87 overall, they're higher overall than us. Edit CPU uniforms. So we'll have black pants. We'll do blue. Yeah. Yeah. Let's see what we can do. I did check on Pow World, by the way, and it's on Steam. Thought it was a PS5 game. 101 reception yards. Man. So we're in London. Kevin Bob, Jalen Ramsey, CJ Stroud. Ominous Sephiroth. Ominous Sephiroth. I think I needed a first name, so I went and did some research, and that was the name of the organization or the special forces that Sephiroth and Cloud were a part of. I don't know. We're kicking off to them. But thankfully, we have Chuck Norris doing the kicking. Whew, come on. Beautiful. Yeah, and right off the bat, I'm going to go into coach adjustments and 44 out of 53, 525 yards, 5 touchdowns, no picks, but 2 losses. So what does it even matter? What are you doing? Yeah, stick to base. Going back matchups, we'll go. Too worried about option until we see kind of what their tendencies are. Those will do default. And now attacking, I want balance. Yeah, I want those to go. I want to be the one in control of who does the heavy hitting. Because I do that determined based on who I have behind me. If I have safety help, yeah, I'll go for a big hit every day. All right, Joe Sherbert looking at their running back, expecting a running play on the first play of the game. I don't think so! Well, there's your first pick of the season, boy! Joe Sherbert, one meaningful play per game. This might be his last season for it, at least on our team. Basically, if I'm going into a trade package and I just need that little bit of extra and they're in the market for an outside linebacker or a middle linebacker, I mean, he deserves a mentor tag. He's been in the league long enough. Now, 29-47, 4-for-4 and 2 interceptions. Both interceptions last game. I mean, they're not Trey Lance numbers, and that's all I care about. Which, by the way, if I was looking on the sidebar on the main screen, Trey Lance is second, leading the league, top 3 in yardage and touchdowns, and that's passing. And that's not even looking at his rushing ability, and he's got some rushing ability. Oh, they're giving Jamar Chase way too much room. Way too much room. Boom. Way too much! I tried to hurdle, but I'll just take the touchdown.
And his name is John C. Ba-ba-da-ba.
Yeah, too much room. Get the catch. I know that he can make one person miss. After that, it's just how embarrassed the other team wants to get. Again, so far, Chuck Norris is perfect. But we did have an opportunity for a 54-yarder last game that we did not take. Thank you.
I'm just walk right into that one.
Okay. Okay, Madden. Okay, Madden. They should have ran the ball, and they didn't.
Don't make me laugh.
They should have ran the ball, and they didn't, and then they did run the ball. And now I don't know. We'll do a cover two hard flat. Yeah, we're good.
Fatality.
My brother! Have a shoulder sandwich, bro! I mean, maybe I should be controlling Luke Kuechly because I want him to have the stats, but I want to have the win, and that was a very quick throw. By quick, I mean I don't think I would have been able to do that in that snap time frame. But as he was coming across, the momentum carried him directly into a... Now, this might be a pass to Jones. Yup. Ow. If the spin move would have worked, the blocking was in place to do something great with it. Fortunately, I think he died. Alright, Jason Kincaid are our primary reads here. Good fake. Yeah, I gotta remember, down the field, the throws are different. Should have been a pick though. The picks are, I moved it up, it was 55, I thought it was 57 before, but I moved it up to 58. Because there are passes that they should be picking that they aren't. Now that guy's good. 92. Is that Fetty? Fetty Perk X? Can't tell. Give me a nameplate or something. Alright, 4th and 9. 41 yarder? Yeah, we're good. Take a turnover every drive. If they only want to do 2-3 plays, turn it over, not even kick it, the whole game will be just peachy for me. I ain't worried about it. Ooh, I didn't even tell him to do that. Is that Kuechly again, 59? Yeah, that was his number in real life, and I changed the number to that. Well, Luke, get on the board, man. I'm expecting a pass. That's usually when I'm wrong. Motions usually indicate...
No yes. Such luck.
Welcome to the floor. Lawrence Guy? No. Franchise guy, 17, baby. This just isn't their game. This might be a running play.
Wow!
And we will take the pickup, but who was supposed to be guarding number 9? That was line flashlight. First pass, first catch of the game. Hey, maybe the yardage, if you're in a PPR league, offset the fumble? I don't think so. Josh Jacobs fumbled. He got stripped. Zazzer, my man. So it looked like, yeah. I mean, they're going to review it, but that looked pretty clean to me. Okay. Booth review. See, they should do that as part of the turnover. But I think that he was slightly above the ground before the ball came out. Just being honest. Oh, they're giving the ball back. Just being honest, it looked to me like his butt bone turned the ball over. My players are too skilled in the crossers game. All right, still no fumbles on the season for our boy Josh Jacobs. Four rushes, 15 yards. Chisel Dodon has taken us down. I want to hit another RPO, I really do. I think a play action would be good in this case. Oh, only one person on chase. I don't think that's smart. Can you block for me? No. I should have sent him up. That's what I should have done. Tyree Wilson. Yep. Let's do a stick and nod here. If that right end crashes, Shakir should have that part of the field after his second break. He crashed. Rose, what am I saying? If the right end crashes, Shakir should have that part of the field after his second break. It's a whip out and then a whip back. So the first one holds the outside to the outside position. Bros, I don't just be saying stuff. You know what I'm saying? Now, of course, I'm over here saying good things are happening. You know, the sliders were changed and it should have been more difficult. But that first pick was user. And then we did fumble, but Madden was like, eh. And we just got the ball again off of a Mike Edwards powerhouse hit. Get yourself some goons. This should not be happening. Oh, we're already close to the field, too. Let's see what Kincaid can do. So the weird thing is we might not reach the yardage total that we were trying to get despite having six or seven touchdowns. That's kind of ridiculous if you think about it. 42 points, 112 yards. I mean, Chuck Norris is getting a leg workout today, putting him on the field so much. Good takedown, good takedown. Fundamentals. But it just feels good to diagnose the play like it. that was good. That was the right pocket to attack. And even if linebackers were like they were in the old Madden days, where they could just fly. I went for the hit stick. I missed. That's okay. I had people behind me. Now, 2-1 is a running start. So, I'm glad we did something, but really? Hey, a little beautiful's in on play. I knew it was a running play. I picked the right side and everything.
I'd like to take this chance to apologize to absolutely nobody.
That whole drive, I was like, everything should be going my way, because everything was going my way. And now, back to earth. Okay, my bad. Don't hate because I'm beautiful. Here we are, a minute left in the first quarter, and we're finally getting a kick to return. See numbers on the left. One-on-one tackle we lost. All right, let's get back out here. This is hot today. It was hot at the end of the game last week, too. I think it's just Don Mason. I'm sorry, Don Omar, my son. It's just his day today. I mean, we're not neglecting the run game, but we got Kincaid coming short. And he's hurt. I mean, we have OJ Howard because we saw this a lot last season, but if he's hurt, take the game, because we also didn't see him a lot last season. I don't know what's happening, but it feels like at the last second, our lineman is going where we need to go. Third and one. We're watching Jacobs leak out. Watching Chase and Jones, but we'll run it if we... Who's that on the left? Khalil Shakir. He is a game wrecker. Wilson really is. Muscle cramps. We'll substitute, get fully well. We will kick. First punt of the game. Alright, so last time it went farther than I thought it was. I'm gonna go backspin. I'm gonna go high. I'm gonna go right here. So that's where I think this should be. Ah. Again, that was 60, 70% power, and it still went as far as it did when I did a full power kick last time. Need to practice that one. We already have 122 passing yards. We're well on our way. But they're getting some, they're building up steam. That was me all the way. Hey, Kier Crossen. Yeah, we out here. Yeah, that was me. Me, baby. See, if I... In my head, I'll have a play that I've guessed. Right. I see the indicators that it's at play. Did you not see my hand? Anyway, if I see the play transpire as I think it should in my head, I'll know where to tell my guys to go. Fortunately, well, the second part of that is if it doesn't look right off the bat like the play that I thought it would be, then I'm going to go to the middle of the field. You know, if I'm in zone, go to the middle, watch a crosser, and stick with it. But man, I will bite so badly. Good drop. Third and four. They picked it up. Low beautiful starting to rack him up now. What a blitz off the left. Yeah, left, my right. Let's see what that looks like.
Don't make me laugh. Woo!
Franchise guy again. Two meaningful tackles behind the line, both of them. Really liking this showing out of franchise guy this day. Somebody off the route.
That was embarrassing.
Bow to me.
Don't let me line them up. Don't let me line up a shot, Madden. Come on. Right, Shakir and Jones.
Perfect.
He might get blinking this game. Man, so somebody should travel with him. They don't. What a run! Josh Jacobs, that was probably the hardest earned run. I mean, more than any other run last season. And between the decisions that had to be made, moving the right direction, that was good. All right, tight end attack. We got OJ Howard and we got Kincaid. That's it. No one else. And we can get some yards on the ground, too. All right, Chase isn't blinking yet, but his light is real yellow. Down in the menu. Two square. Yeah. Oh my God! What a powerhouse, baby! I'm telling you, Josh Jacobs and Ja'Marr Chase, best picks for my first two in the fantasy draft. Best, no better combination. That was all him. The catch, first of all, was a secure catch. He should have went down. He said, I got you, coach. I said, yeah, but the goal line's right there, coach. I said, yeah, well, yes, it is. I mean, wouldn't it be better if I just did this? And then he went through everybody. And 65 yards, too. We had a couple of short yardages, and then Marcel Chase said, gimme. And Josh Jacobs had a good run. I'm a bruiser, baby. I'll do a cover contain. He's not really breaking the pocket, but let's just gives us a chance to focus on our guys. And he dropped it too good because of the contact. Kind of seemed a little morphy to me. Did he try to knock it back in? The Patriots did that once. I think it was Stephon Gilmore jumped, tapped it. It was met inbound.
You better run, boy!
And he cut right at the first yard marker. Good job, Kevin Bob. Good job. I'm guessing a run on this. If I knew how.
My name is Shake Sula, the mic ruler, the old schooler. You want a trick? I'll bring it to ya.
Well, that was very Madden. Keekly behind the line. Sticking with him. By the way, I don't know if you guys are as excited as I am about yes, please stop it. Okay, I'm noticing that if I'm in zone, Luke Keekly's hurt. And he's going to the locker room. Hopefully it's just a random animation because they don't know what they're talking about. Yeah, we'll go back to the I'm noticing that if they're in zone, if their assignment, like here, like look, like Phillips, his assignment's way over there. Then you know what? Maybe he should be over there.
I am evil Homer. I am evil Homer.
Ian Thomas? Alright, so it's this one. It's this one. So what did I have it by before? Interesting. We'll do that for, because they're in the red zone here. Stick to base. First and goal on the one. Oof, I was ready. I was ready to Palomalu that thing. And meet him. Corn label.
Get that out of here!
Yeah, there's too many of us back there. Come on. Anyway, I don't know if you guys are as excited as I am about the upcoming draft because we found a custom draft class made. And there were two coming in, so I stuck with the inside one. But Michael Thomas, I haven't seen that animation before. Boom, right into the goalpost. CJ Stroud, Michael Thomas looked up. Second touchdown of the game for the London Monarchs. They've been doing it for a while. There's already been thousands of downloads. But this class is supposed to be a very accurate reflection on the upcoming real life draft class. Originally, I was kind of opposed to that, but at the same time, when somebody puts in that much work, you know it's going to be good. Block for me. Mmm, okay. Yeah, one more hit would have been bad, but when I saw that line, especially when I saw him block, I was like, okay, this might be something great. JJ up the middle. Good. Another 10-yard run. 7 rushes. 50 yards. We're seeing the JJ from last year reemerge. And no reason to injure him. Catch the ball. Go out of bounds. Get yourself a catch while you're at it. This gun escape, so it's a Texas route that then goes out towards the outline. So it's really a levels concept to the right. I love that.
Deadly.
I should have thrown it away. I think if I had another moment, great things could have happened. But I didn't, and I should have thrown it away. That's a 2-minute warning. Was that halftime? Oh. Not top tens. That was a block 10 clock management right there. St. Louis Rams against the Buenos Aires Condors. No, Buenos Aires or the Dragons. Anyway, Kyler Murray, Manu Ginobili, Lionel Messi, good things. All right, Vancouver Snowhawks going to the Memphis Armadillos. Currently in the second, about to be the 2-minute warning. Snowhawks up 14-0. Lamar Jackson, 98 yards on 7 throws. Anthony Richardson, last year, did not even make the top 10 offensive rookie of the year performances. Indigo Montoya versus Trey Lance, our old boy, deuces, 7-7. With Paris visiting the U.S. That was a good run by Beautiful. It was a beautiful run. I've got to admit. At the time, I was analyzing how Madden it was, but then we also had a beautiful catch of our own. So what are we going to do now? We're going to start running to the outside. We have a lot of those plays coming up, and I want to pick them. And I think defending the short pass has been working for us, especially if we keep it short. Although, if this continues, if we manage to pull away a little bit more, we might be seeing the strategy shift on their end, which will force us to return the favor. 7 yards per carry on Josh Jacobs. 2 very big rushes. In fact, I think he had 3 of 10 or more, but he's not blinking. So he needs one more rush of 10 yards or more. Jamar Chase needs 22 more 20-yard receptions. There's one, and it's blink time, baby. Oh, now it's on. Now we do an outside run. Try to isolate one guy. And I'll shift to it if I can, but right now, Kincaid's going out if it's safe, but Jamar Chase, yeah. As soon as I threw it, he bumped and then recoiled a bit off of the safety there. And I'll tell you why. Because as soon as you hit the throw button, Madden decides what's going to happen. That's when it decides. Another 5-yard run. I know one guy ate some shoulder sandwiches. All right, slot cross. Ooh, again, I'm looking at Chase and just thinking this might be one.
No.
Yeah, we're on the 44. I feel like that should have been caught. Backspin. Nice. One thing about Gilligan Island, his backspin is almost like he played Aussie football. Which, if that's a type of kicker, then you can be. Wow, quick throw. If that's a type of kicker, that, like, you can choose different throwing styles, traditional, gunslinger. I think there's other ones, I don't know. You can choose the style of kicker. I think that's pretty cool. I'm going to do this to cover up that tight end because I'm supposed to be covering over him. Yeah. Sherbert's having a great day. That was one of those plays that Madden gives somebody Hulk-like shield and invincibility. But I did the first wave of slowing him down. Couldn't outdo three tackles. Looked like he was about to outdo two. Who's coming to the middle? Yeah, we're set up against short passes, but they are just getting these short passes. I thought 21 was coming up. Do I have him at 0 or 5? Let's do 5. Oh, I met you there. Still got the first, but those are starting to become dangerous. Do a fireman. Fireman coming. Risky, risky, risky. But we'll put turnaround on the flat and we'll just smack the middle of that box. Like we knew it was coming. Having a good first half, 10 for 61, starting to show a little signs of decline there. Here, with three wide receivers, we'll do a double safety blitz and we'll do a triangle up, keep everybody in front.
Burn and dig the countryside.
I guess that puts everybody on a one-on-one and we can't always win those. The line flashlight. Third score of the game for the Monarchs. Slant to the inside. A lot of inside throws. So I think that's what I'm going to game plan against on their next drive. We're only up by 10 points. Should have been more, I know. We lost track of time at the end of the first half. Yards per carry. Josh Jacobs doing mean, hurtful things to this offense. Oh, no. Oh. Y'all saw. You guys know what's going on. Oh, if that would have been a faster... I went for a truck. I should have went for a juke like I did last time. That could have been great. Okay, play action here. Looking at Chase again. If we can get him blinking, we will. That's when it starts to show how bad of a game this is, because what decision was made there? Animation-wise, for that to happen, like, the throw was made, it was on time, it was in a clean area of the field.
Tiger.
What a juke to get more yards. 12 for 17, 183. I'm not a big fan of toss plays, and that might just be bad taste of Madden 21 and Madden 16 in my mouth, but let's not forget who do we have? Your boy. 7.8 yards per carry now. Went from 7.5, 7.8. Another stretch play. He's blinking. It's our game plan. Can we get one of you guys over to the left? Oh, yeah. Yeah, respect Jones, because you know. Get through! Get it, stay in bounds, and score me a touchdown, JJ! Pew! That was just, first of all, to recognize that if I motioned someone and they didn't travel, we would have had the numbers in the blocking. Second, trusting Josh Jacobs. Could Luke Bayless have done that? No. He would have gotten the first down, but that was beautiful. That was our game plan. That was our strength. That was his superstar X factor. That's just recognizing all that stuff put together, and it's no longer a 10-point game, 38-21. Once you got London, Monarchs, more problems. Come on. Two minutes left in the third quarter. And we ain't letting up. Hey, Julian Farr got in on that tackle. Last drive, 6 for 6, 76 yards. So you know what? We have to make that more difficult. We really do. We'll start with a cover 2. Austin's out here. Far is in the middle of the box.
Oh boy, here I go killing again.
Good time for a run, right?
So I missed.
And that was me again. Oh, a fumble. I didn't even make him do that. Covered his own fumble. They're already I feel like going in for it. Going for the kill. Man, they are coming inside. So I'm gonna man up. I know it's risky, but I'm gonna man up. Triangle inside. Come on, Duck Dodgers. Come on, man. I hate it when you successfully execute the maneuver and they just put somebody else in the way. Like, not even intentionally, like that was part of the play. It was just, oops. So how is that not illegal contact? Where I'm just strafing to the right and they just rub pick play on me. Come on. But here we are. Four wide receivers going into the fourth quarter. 171 passing yards, 163 rushing yards. Great game. We're only 37 yards from our rushing goal. So kudos to our team there. I just got pancakes. Fire! play we called recently wasn't in our recent play calls.
Time to play the game.
And of course, the play that they called for us
time to play
was
the game.
Perfectly blocked by the team. Perfectly executed off on offense because of the formation we came out of. They should almost have a ticker that just says, just like in real life, not everything works out. Because if that's the explanation, then, you know, what you gotta do? What a stiff arm. It was only 2 yards, but those were two earned yards. So do a strong stretch with Luke Bayless. Not expecting much from him. We have numbers on the left.
And that's the bottom line. The Stone Cold sets up.
Oh my God, no way! Kind of the same thing. I made sure the numbers were good. When I got there, I saw that my two blockers went out and went at the second level. The blocks were held. Then I went, crashed, and cut left. Then on that one, I did a stutter step. And they both worked. And Luke Bayless with longest run of the game. First, I think that's his first touchdown of the season. He's a rookie. And we met our 200-yard goal. We are happy with that. .45-28, 73-yard run. And I don't want to jinx it by going, come at me, all Madden, but I just did, didn't I? Keep down! King Koopa's out here. Who laid the hit? I want to see that in the replay. Who laid the hit? Was it Mike Edwards again? Because Mike Edwards hit one earlier. Kaboom! Number 14. Yeah, Mike Edwards. It has like every three games last season. And remember, he's not a starter. In fact, last season he was a third string safety. Like, we had two starting safeties, a backup safety for either one, and then he was the backup to the backup. We very rarely saw the field. And still, he made impact. Does that mean he should be a starter? No, that means he's a great... He's the sixth man. You know what I'm saying? Like, when he comes off the bench, be scared. Notice some screen tearing, so I'm probably going to reduce the size. It's nice to have it bigger, but I don't want to have visual problems.
Let's get organized, hmm?
You guys. Oh, woo!
The Dodgers in the 24th and a half century!
Left silent on purpose for sound effects. Duck Dodgers. Hey, Bowser's on the field, too. I guess he wants more.
That's an air ball.
Yeah, pressure. Pressure. I just felt like crashing. If the slant had been to me and he ran that up for a touchdown, I would be like, yeah, I abandoned my position, but I just felt like it. Great reason, right? Old screen.
Boom shakalaka!
Did you see the recovery after he did the animation? It was beautiful. 400 yards from the London Monarchs. 317 of them passing. Means that they broke the 100-yard barrier for rushing as well.
Falcon punch!
But we out here bringing the pain. No sacks last game, just like the first four games of the season last season. But our defensive line's getting it together. Another screen. Yeah, baby. Third and 18. We do recover three. I'll send Barmore on a flat, and I'll try to get in there with Dougie.
And there just ain't room enough on this planet for the two of us.
Teach me how to ducky, baby. Duck dodges with another sack. I like that animation too. Another sack. Pushed him not only in there, I was going to say out of field goal range, out of contention to go for it, but they're really, really down. I'm surprised that wasn't illegal contact. And a schwat. Yeah, y'all ain't got to be happy. Out here though. The game's pretty much in the books. Twelve rushes, 128 yards and a touchdown for Josh Jacobs. We'll pick up three right there. Stick to our game plan. Another 4 or 5. Yep, 32. Can we get Luke Bayless in for a run? Let's look at Jamar Chase. Play action. Probably a good time for. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Either Kincaid or Chase is going to get this. Or. Or my son to get out here and remind them who we are and what we do. Oh, Chase might get this one. Nope. Is he blinking? Oh, he's blinking. Oh, we're too close to the red zone to really make it effective, but play action here. Yeah, he's not blinking. Chase might get this one.
Get that out of here!
Elite Drowsy with an elite play. Not gonna lie, that was actually really good. Alright, Zay Jones, what kind of stuff we got for you? Double slant on 3rd and 3. Again, we might just run it. But we'll see what happens with Chase, Kincaid, and all that. Ooh, that should have been picked. Yeah, that should have been picked. Whatever, it gives Chuck Norris a chance to get some XP. We're not turning down points unless we forget that it's halftime. Who said that? Oh my God! Werner with a fumble caused and a recovery, and that was Amon Asseparov. But Werner said, didn't you want to make that a touchdown? Said, yeah. That's a chance. Might go to OJ. Whoa. Didn't even have a chance to set the feet from the snap. It happens. Do an 0-1 trap. Oh no, they are. Oh man, this is gonna hurt. Oh my god, I should have snapped them all. Really? I was gloating about them being in the worst possible position. Read option, huh? Read option, huh? Interesting. I mean, who would you think it would go to? I mean, who's been great all game? You know what I'm saying? And he got back by one guy, too. All right, third and goal. Throwing dagger here, but I'm gonna tell Kincaid to go flat and Shakir to curl.
Come here.
Wow!
Get over here!
I'm not sure. I don't know who that guy was, but with the left outside linebacker turns around, I said I was gonna go for it. Could have thrown it to circle as well. But this is why you. When you have this kind of a player, you have to focus on break sack his man. And I'm pretty sure that was Chiseled Adonis. Or in his opinion, the superior Josh Allen. Adding to the rushing total, I think we definitely got the rushing yards, the offensive yards, I think we got that too. And now it's just a matter of 133 yards on 5 receptions for line flashlight. Let me send him a picture of that. And go up. Can Duck go for 3?
About this.
Oh my god, he got 3! Oh my god, did you see that? The Superman! Duck Dodgers with his 3rd sack of the game.
Double kill!
Oh no, Peyton Turner got hurt. Oh, not worth it. Not worth it, man. Cramps? Is he going into the medical tent? Oh, they should have a medical tent animation. Can Dodgers get a safety? Fourth and 29. And they're punting. And I kind of want to rush it to get a safety, but no need. What a kick. I should have went left. I don't know what I'm doing. I'll go to where I see the guys so that I know how to break their ankles, but really you should just go away from the guys. Quadriceps strain. Might be more than just this game, but we're... I don't think we'll be missing him the rest of the season. That's all. That's what we don't want. Yeah, I know. I shouldn't. I've already had injuries. But people need the ball. Mason needs his numbers. I mean, ouch. That looked painful. You know what, Jean-Luc Picard, we ain't forgot about you. timeout, kick field. Kick field goal, call it a game. The game we came into, scared. Whew. He barely made that one, I felt like. But we came into this game scared. Their defense especially looked hard to beat. But they were 0-2 before us, despite being a better overall. And we kind of exposed that. It's kind of like the Jaguars after the Saxonville year. Where you have great expectations for these guys, but when you know what you're doing, you know how to beat them. It's not always suppress them to under 100 yards or outrun them by 100 yards. It's not necessarily that. It might be they're going to make mistakes if you keep letting them do this or you keep guiding them towards a one-dimensional offense or defense and then exploiting that. And that's exactly what we did. 25 for 32, 78% completion. Although this I'm liking because we saw a stretch of six games last year with 85 and above completion percentage, and we're talking backup quarterbacks. This is more like it. Three touchdowns, one pick. His first pick of the season was the first pass that he threw in this game, but then from that point forward, 323 yards, you can't be mad at that. You also can't be mad at four touchdowns, even though he only had 200 yards. With good field position comes great opportunity, comes great responsibility. But 68% completion percentage, 15 for 22. Now let's take a look at who they threw it to. First of all, line flashlight, running's not your thing, man. But we'll get to what your thing is in just a moment. But low beautiful, 13 for 86, 6.6 carry average. We tried our best, and there were a couple of times that he just got away from us. Did get a touchdown with a long of 32, two 20-yard runs. Now, if you really want to know who was amazing, I was going to say Josh Jacobs, but I kind of forgot for a second that this guy had a 73-yard run. Like, I just need one play, coach. We're 73 yards out, Luke. We don't want to be 74 when you're done. I've got something else in store for you, coach. Cool. Luke Bayless, one carry, 73 yards for a touchdown. Jean-Luc Ricard, one carry for 2 yards. Got us into field goal range. He helped us out a little bit with that. But also had a catch that was... He does his thing really well. Don Omar Mason. So got 6 carries. More like he broke the pocket 6 times. 5 times. And then had one option. That was a designed run. 58 yards out of it, 9.6 per carry, and a score. But Josh Jacobs, 135 yards, one touchdown, 9.6 carry average, just like our boy Don Omar. But that's incredible. It's good to see him back and healthy and dominating like he was before. But speaking of line flashlights, primo opportunity, let's start with, he doesn't matter. 3 for 19 yards, Alan Lazard. 4 for 50 and a touchdown. Not a bad fantasy day. Kevin Bob out here, 5 for 29. 5 for 29. So it might seem like a low average, but I wish that one of the stats that they would demonstrate is first downs gotten. Because if he caught the ball, it was like, wow, good catch. But line flashlight, 5 catches, 133 and 2 touchdowns. 133 yards on his own. Low beautiful, though. 7 catches for 83 yards. 7 catches, great. Great stuff. But player of the game on their side, got to be line flashlight. Now, for us, we're seeing more people on this list than we usually have. Although we do have a couple of one catchers. Khalil Shakir and Jean-Luc. Now, Shakir had a great game last game. But this one, he had 1 for 18. It was for a score, though. Jean-Luc had 1 for 12. Good average. Keep that one up. Josh Jacobs, 2 catches, 20 yards. Said, I can do more than just run, coach. It's like, just run? You call your running just running? Dalton Kincaid, 2 for 27 and a touchdown. Zay Jones, 3 for 57, but the player of the game, Ja'Marr Chase, 6 catches, 2 touchdowns for 79 yards. Fantastic stuff. There was blocking. Defensively speaking, this is going to have a lot of people on it. So first we'll look at tackles for a loss. Because today we had a bit, and it all came in the fourth quarter, if I can recall correctly. Although a couple of runs were stuffed pretty early. Luke Kuechly, 1 tackle for a loss with 2 tackles total. Injury designation, that's not good. Adrian Phillips, 1 tackle for a loss with 8 total tackles. Deron Payne, 1-1. Peyton Turner also injured, 1 tackle for a loss, 1. Now, Joe Sherbert, 2 tackles for a loss, 1 interception. That first interception, the first play of the game, I started crossing left. If I saw the handoff, it was going to be a crash. If I saw no handoff, I was just going to kind of keep going. I kept going, saw one of the offensive players turn up and said, let me get into that part of the field. User. Also caused a forced fumble. Great game by Joe. Franchise guy, 3 tackles for a loss, brother. Appreciate that. Those were all of his tackles. We're behind the line. And then Duck Dodgers in the 24th and a half century. 4 tackles for a loss. 3 sacks. Crushing game. Crushing quarter, really. It was all in the fourth quarter. But crushing quarter by Duck Dodgers. Increíble. Javon Holland and Mike Edwards each had 2 forced fumbles. We also had 1 from Pete Werner, Adoree Jackson, and Joe Sherbert. Adoree Jackson, I have not called your name yet. 3 total tackles, none for a loss. That would be why. 3 for 3, 8 for 8, 8 scores. 8 for 8 and 3 for 3. Still 100% on the season. If he gets to the Pro Bowl, maybe he might actually be good. It's disguising the fact that he can't kick very far. Gilligan's Island, 2 for 79 yards on punting. For a kick return, 22-yard average on 3 kick returns for Calvin Austin. Last game had a return for 102 yards. And this is I'm going to take him off of punt return duty because if he's going to be average, I'll give that to somebody else, but I don't want him to get hurt. But that was the game. Finito. I think tomorrow I might be streaming some either Titanfall or Fortnite. Yeah, we didn't allow 24 points or less, but we got the 200 rushing yards, and we did get 450 total offensive yards. So 22 franchise points on the game. We'll deal with that at the end of training next week. Quick look at the scouts and region breakdown. So for the scouts, we've cross-referenced outside linebacker, defensive end, safety, 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 because safety is something that we're definitely going to be investing heavy in this offseason coming up. Plus, gave us the opportunity to get Rondé Barber on our side again, back from the Oklahoma City Nighthawk days. Plus, I have his card in Mutt as a starter. But Curtis Caldwell, we're also cross-referencing cornerbacks, and we do have 1 person looking at wide receivers because if we find a late-round gem, that's probably where we're going to look. So good stuff there. There's already a mock draft. Let's see where they have us going because last year they kind of didn't like what they did. So they're thinking Marvin Harrison Jr. is going to go to the Tokyo Thunderbirds. They just drafted Son Goku, a wide receiver. They think Caleb Williams is going to be the first quarterback off the board, but that's going to go to the Lumberjacks, who currently have Kirk Cousins as their number one, who's been renamed to Paul Bunyan. And then Jared Verse, left end, going first overall, despite top five, and just a round one projection. So interesting. Terrion Arnold, cornerback, right tackle, Felicia Fugua. And then left tackle, Joe Alt. So we're seeing some offensive linemen. Another one here, left tackle. Then Dallas Turner on the right outside linebacker section. So They think, first, we're looking at ourselves and our division opponents. So right off the bat, they're thinking that the worst in our division is going to be the Shamrocks, who are definitely the, arguably the strongest team in our division, is the Salt Lake City Shamrocks. So very interesting that they're going to be placed this low, or thought of so low, to speak to their record at the end of the season. Then the Monarchs, who we just played and beat, Marius Rims, right tackle, 14th spot, so about midway, so maybe a slight losing record. Then next up, the Orbits quarterback. They think the Orbits are going to go for a quarterback. Interesting. Now, there's already a Kool-Aid McKinstry, because I like the name. And somebody had a post about him on Reddit. I was like, nah, I need to have that guy on one of my teams. So we have one. We'll see where this one goes. And that'll be an interesting one-on-one comparison. Bo Nix, Braylon Trice, Murphy. The Oilers getting a right tackle. A lot of offensive linemen. And they think we're going to go 26. So what, losing the wild card? Get a right end, Darius Robinson. We are going to get a right end. And we might move up to do it. And we'll look more closely at the prospects another week. But I looked at our schedule, and week 3 schedule says renegotiate. So we'll take a big swing by doing this. Watch. We want Josh Jacobs for the rest of his days. We want Zay Jones. We want Christian Barmore. Zay Jones, though, he might be a casualty. King Koopa, Green re-sign. We're probably going to try to keep those guys. Keon Crossing, we got Deion Sanders as our scout, so you might be leaving. Put you on the trade block. Yeah, same thing with you, because we'll be drafting your position at better than what you are right now, and you're just here as a mentor. So, yeah, the big deal is going to be these three guys: Josh Jacobs, Zay Jones, King Cooper. But he's going to cost money. Obviously, 33 over 4 years. So what we're going to do is invest some of our franchise points in keeping him home. He wants to come back. We want him to come back. And I don't know if you heard the old adage, but this is how we do it. This is how we do it. No. 4% trade value increase for user draft picks. Likelihood that left tackle signed to free agency. What about that's trades? That's all free agency. What about CPU draft picks? Draft pick, non-X factor, trade discount. Not even an option. So I must not have the right combination of personnel. Ooh, speed of outside linebackers though. That's trades. Man. Makes me sad. We're gonna have to do this kind of on our own, which, hate to tell you, I would rather have an edge. We might be losing Josh Jacobs, and I don't want that. So really, the only way to make sure that doesn't happen is to give him what he wants. This is the only way. I mean, the scheme fit and the historic championships are player motivations that we just won it with him. So, man. Now we'll compare this to the player friendly. So 13 and 9, 12 and 8.5. It's that hurts. I wish we could see how much money we have. This would be the right place to put that, don't you think? We have remaining cap $73 million. So, come on, man. We got him for 5 years, if I remember to change that. So, 5 years. All right, let's take one good. Now, Zay Jones is 29. So, they're both 29. Yikes. But I mean, 76 overall, 15 million over 3 years, 2 million over 1 year. You're gonna get what you want. I mean, you're cheap. Yeah, cool. You're not, though. You're really not. And we have Khalil Shakir, and we have Calvin Austin. And they're rising up. So we'll check in on you again in a couple of weeks. All right, so he's a captain. He's a captain. Good. And we need a captain on defense. Yeah, award-winning Adoree Jackson. Can I make him a cap? Yeah. Who else on defense deserves it? No, tried to leave us last year. Peyton Turner, you're all right, though. That's about it. Deron Payne, good. He's already a captain. I was going to say, he's been here. Devin Lloyd, 25 years old. And that's important because if he's going to be with us a while, yeah. Yeah, definitely. Because he can go from getting that one gold star all the way across because you have to stay as a captain in consecutive years. So, cool, Coolio to that. Sorry, man. Oh, I really just... I don't want Dontavian Wicks. That's who I don't want. Anybody else that needs to go on the trade block? Y'all understand how much that hurts my soul. He's a member of the team, of the family. If you weren't 28, I'd make you a captain as well. I mean, you know what? There's three on offense, three on defense. And we would be nowhere without that offensive line. trade him, but at the same time, he's not ready to be the primary. You know, these are good fill-in backups. Even Kerryon Winfrey can't really move around that much. Right now, we have Adoree Jackson while we are raising Greg in nobility. Feels good to have Isaiah Rodgers back, and we're going to have him for years to come. But Adoree Jackson, you're not going anywhere. Super Bowl MVP, sticking with us. And then a couple good pickups here with Kelly Ringo and Greedy Williams. We don't need this guy. Alright, he's already on the trade block. But that's all the work that we're going to do today. So we've checked our scouts. We've made sure that our captains and trade blocks are good. We've secured the bag for Josh Jacobs and for King Koopa Bowser. But Barmore, we'll have to think about it. Last thing we're going to do ...4 weeks without Luke Kuechly. 4 weeks, man. Next week, we'll have to make sure to put King Koopa Bowser back over on the left side in his absence. Deep accuracy for quarterbacks, okay. That's worth it. We have 68 points left. Let's throw under pressure. Okay. Throw power. Wow. And then cost 27. We only have 23. Catching for wide receivers and tight ends. This here. Run block for tight ends. Yeah, we'll do that. And next week when we have enough, we will make a decision on awareness, stiff arm, and strength for halfbacks and trucking. Or run block for fullbacks, impact block for fullbacks, lead block for fullbacks, trucking for halfbacks. I think it's going to be this side. But we shall see. In the meantime, appreciate you rocking with me. Another win. Not as tough fought as last week, and the sliders were more in their favor this week. So maybe I'm just getting better as a player. I watch MCS. On occasion. Next week we face the Oilers and Zach. If you want to know who I'm talking about, tune in then. But for now, this is fun. Another game in the books. More players have been cameoed, introed, outroed, however you want to call it. And just so you know, we are ahead of schedule in terms of games, but there's a few techniques that I'm learning and trying to employ, and I'm trying to diversify the sound portfolio in terms of effects and music. So, but hopefully they'll start rolling out with a little bit more consistency. But the streaming has been consistent. Follow me on Twitch, Dimasa III, on Fridays and Saturdays. On Tuesdays, I'm trying to do YouTube direct streaming. Currently, I'm in the trial of Skull and Bones, and I'm giving my points of negative and positive. As I've been playing it so far, I'm halfway through the trial, and you should be able to find that on my other tabs here. But that all being said, next one should be coming out as quickly as I can, I promise.